Hello everyone, let's talk about this UI that lets you add an emoji reaction to a chat message. If someone asks you to build a UI like this one, I'm sure that you'll quickly have a feeling that it won't be an easy task. Indeed, if we look at it more closely, we can see that we need to implement buttons with custom shapes, several animations, and even a transition to animate the chat message back and forth. All that to say that there's definitely at least a few days of work to build such a UI. And this got me thinking, what if we try to implement a simplified version that would only use the built-in building blocks of SwiftUI? Would it be possible to implement it quickly and with a result that still looks polished enough? That's what we're going to find out in this video. But first, I have a big thank you for the sponsor of this video, Stream. Stream is an SDK that offers all the features that you need if you want to add instant messaging to your app. So if you plan to add a chat feature, you probably want to check out what they offer before you start spending a lot of time implementing all of it by yourself. And by the way, Stream has also gained new features in addition to instant messaging. They also offer real-time video calls and activity feeds. So once again, I have a big thank you to Stream, and if you want to learn more about all they can offer, you have a link in the description. And now, let's get started. We are going to use an app that implements a very simple chat feature. I will only show you the parts of the code that are relevant, but you have a link in the description to access the full codebase. Let's focus on the view chat bubble, which displays each chat message. To implement an emoji reaction, we need to display the UI when the user long presses on a chat message. To do this, we are going to use a built-in modifier of SwiftUI called contextMenu. As its name suggests, this modifier lets us define a series of buttons which will be displayed in a contextMenu when the user long presses on a chat bubble. If we give it a try, we'll see that indeed it works, we can add an emoji reaction. However, notice that there's an issue in the UI. When the user long presses on the chat bubble, we can see a white rectangular shape appear behind the chat bubble. And that's a problem that we need to solve because it really conveys a feeling of poor quality. Fortunately, it's quite easy to fix when you know the right modifier to use. We're going to use the modifier ContentShape. We'll pass it the same shape as for the modifier clip shape. However, we'll also specify that the shape should be applied for the context menu preview. And as we can see, by using the modifier content shape with the right arguments, now the UI looks perfectly clean. Of course, we could keep improving, for example, by adding a small animation and a haptic feedback when the reaction is added. But our goal has been achieved. We've been able to implement an emoji reaction feature using only SwiftUI built-in building blocks, and we saw that it didn't require too much effort. And if you're curious to see how to implement emoji reactions from scratch without using a SwiftUI context menu, I've put a link in the description of how Stream implemented the feature in their SDK. You'll see that it indeed involves quite a bit of work. That's all for this video, I hope that you've enjoyed it. Remember that you have a link in the description to access the full codebase of the app I've used in this video. Once again, I have a big thank you to Stream for sponsoring this video. If you need to implement instant messaging, video calls, or an activity feed in your app, check out what they offer, it's the first link in the description. Thank you for watching, and see you next time!